This is on the rise. Mumbai Coworking in this scenario is helping Mumbai-based startups and MSMEs work in a quirky yet flexible environment. Shubhangi Sinha has the story.
I would like to work in a place where I can take breaks whenever I want for whatever I want.
I'm a workaholic. Okay, so I like my work environment having an ambitious vibe.
I like to start my day early.
I'm not at all a morning person.
I feel fresh, you know, with a fresh mind I can easily approach my clients.
Come on, good afternoon, it's a good new good morning.
All the world's a stage, Shakespeare once said. But who knew? Everyone wanted a different looking stage, or in this case, a different looking desk. In a constantly growing working body of millennials, finding an office space to satiate their many needs could be taxing for a company, and especially so for an MSME in India. Creating a flexible work environment for MSMEs, startups and entrepreneurs is the company Mumbai Coworking. Founded by Waqar Azmi in 2016, this Mumbai-based co-working space is home to many a dreamers.
Waqar, we live in an increasingly collaborative world, and this is of course seeped into office spaces as well. So what was the inspiration behind starting Mumbai Coworking?
So if you understand, like, in a place like Bombay, where real estate, you know, be it residential or commercial, is quite expensive. Now when you go and take up an office of your own, you probably need to pay at least 4-5 months as deposit. Then there is a brokerage that needs to be paid. You need to get into like a 11-month lock-in period. Now when people are starting up, or they are in this whole initial moonlighting phase of a startup, they don't want to commit so much of capital upfront, one. Secondly, they want to probably try it out and see how the venture goes and which direction it works for 2-3 months, and then probably take a decision how they want to move forward. So taking into that consideration, I think that's a huge driving factor. Besides that, I think that there are a lot of people who are working out of home, and I think they want a professional setup. I think a lot of these people, they want to, are looking for opportunities or space where they could probably also collaborate and, like, you know, thrive together and work with other co-workers, like-minded individuals.
Right, so like you were saying, that this is a place where a lot of people can come in and work exactly how they want to. Do you think that it is possible for co-working spaces to maintain the correct balance of quirkiness and also allowing for a space where people can do some serious business?
I'll be honest with you, in our case, the largest company that we would have is about 12 people, which is mainly a casting agency. And then there are much more smaller players, like there are like 3-4 people team. So these are very initial teams. Like, you know, they themselves are in a co-working space and they're trying to figure out them, business and other things. So honestly, they themselves haven't embodied a very strong culture. So they are, in a way, they kind of get mixed into our own culture, the way we've kind of designed the space. And I think people who come here, they like that quirkiness, they like that liveliness, they like the fact that, you know, there are colors on the wall, and then, you know, like in a way, it kind of lightens them up and they kind of connect with this.
Now, talking about the other side of the co-working space, which is itself the design of the space. Now, there are a lot of studies which say that, you should have some certain ratio of meeting rooms and cubicles. How do you view this, and do you think that this is something which is necessary to keep in mind while opening a co-working space?
Honestly, so there's one factor that I look at is what the average cost of the seat. Let's just say in our case, it's like about $1,500. Should only be the 25% of the cost that we sell for. So basically, the number of seats that we create in an office space or whatever space that we take up, it should be, the base cost should be just 25% of the average cost that we sell for. And obviously, the fact that it is quirky and it is lively, and, you know, to be honest, to design a quirky space, it doesn't take much money, but it requires creativity, which I think we are good at. Yeah.
Right, now, how difficult or easy would you say is it for a co-working space business to break even? Because of course, the cost of real estate, the cost of the power, etc., comes on the owner. So how difficult or easy is it to break even?
It is not easy. I can tell you there are tons of people who are trying to do co-working or this whole shared office space. I think it requires quite a lot of effort in terms of identifying what, whom are you targeting, how will you target that? I think marketing is a huge challenge, because let's just be honest, how do you market? It is not a typical B2B corporate sales, nor it's like a typical B2C game, right? So in a way, you need to target a certain very niche kind of people, which are typically your freelancers or small startups or people who are trying to set up office in different regions.
Right, but Waqar, I think there are a lot of co-working spaces which are mushrooming across the city and India as well. So what do you think in that case is your USP, and what really sets Mumbai co-working apart?
I think affordability, the value that we deliver for the cost that we take, is amazing. I follow this saying which says, like, you know, price is what you pay, value is what you get, right? So I totally believe in whatever the price that they pay, they need to get more value. So for example, unlike other co-working spaces where they give you coupons for coffee and stuff, we have unlimited coffee and tea, right? We do these bunch of tie-ups and all where there is free food flowing somewhere through some or the other brand that we work with. Besides that, the flexibility that we offer, we are not very typical where we'll shut the AC at 6:30 or 7 o'clock, unlike some of the other business centers and stuff. So if somebody wants to work like maybe one night late till about 10-11, we give them that flexibility. We give them some flexibility in terms of making some payments also, right? I think unlike other co-working spaces, they are very stern about making sure the rental comes on a certain day. So I think affordability, flexibility, the value that we deliver, I think are three most important things which helps us do well in this space.
Right, let's talk about our global peers then. Countries like the US have co-working spaces which are opening dedicated spaces for women workers. Do you think that creating a niche like this could possibly be viable in India?
So honestly, right now, it's in a very initial phase. It would be tough to comment, like, you know, to whether you can make a space which is co-working for only for women. And I think it's a little regressive also. What I definitely see is this whole co-sharing and co-working kind of concept booming up.
Revolutionizing the concept of office spaces and bringing the importance of community in a workplace to the fore, Mumbai Coworking is ensuring that companies and individuals alike can be at their productive best, irrespective of whether they are early risers or believe in burning the night oil.